Hello, beautiful people of the internet. What's up? It's your girl, Lakisha. In today's video, I'm going to be sharing some of my tips and tricks for incorporating retinols into your skincare routine for the very first time. Of course, if this is your first time seeing my face, my name is Lakisha. I'm a skincare enthusiast, and I post a lot of videos on skincare, makeup, hair, and lifestyle. If that is something you're interested in, then make sure you are subscribed. Without further ado, let's get started. Just to make sure that we're all on the same page, here is a little bit about retinoids. A retinoid is an umbrella term for a family of vitamin A, the strongest of that being retinoic acid. Now, studies have shown that retinoic acid applied directly to the skin has amazing benefits for the skin, but it does come with its fair share of side effects, and it tends to be a very irritating ingredient to pretty much every single skin type. In order to combat some of this irritation and ensure that your skin is still receiving the maximum benefits, different strains of retinoids have been created. This is what we're talking about when we say that the ingredient has to be converted one or two times or three times to become retinoic acid, which is how your skin actually receives the ingredient. So depending on how many conversions the ingredient is away from retinoic acid will determine the strength of it. For example, a retinol is two conversions away from retinoic acid, meaning that it tends to be a little bit more gentle on the skin, whereas a retinol ester is even further away from retinoic acid, which means that it'll be significantly better tolerated by the skin. Products that you'll find that are already in the form of retinoic acid, such as tetraenoin, as well as Accutane, are only available by prescription of a dermatologist. But there are very strong forms of retinols that you can find that are over-the-counter or OTC. Don't get me wrong, retinoids are very powerful ingredients, but depending on how many conversions they are away, you'll find that rather than taking 3 months, it may take 6 months and 9 months, even a year and more to see a result, depending on how low the percentage is. But that's not necessarily a bad thing. For the purpose of this video, I'm going to be referring to the family of retinoids as retinol, simply because it is the most common word that's used to describe vitamin A. A common misconception about retinols is that it's an exfoliator, and this is just simply not true. A retinol is an antioxidant, it's a skin-restoring ingredient, and it works by increasing the cell turnover rate of your skin cells, bringing new skin cells to the surface. How many times in this video will I say skin cells? I have no idea. Comment it down below. It's one of the only ingredients that are scientifically proven to actually improve the quality of your skin, leaving it looking more healthy, smooth, and vibrant. However, retinol tends to be very drying to the skin, which results in a few side effects, such as acne, dryness, flaking, and even peeling of the skin, which leads people to believe that it is actually exfoliating your skin. This is not the case. As you're bringing more skin cells to the surface, the dead skin is left up on the top, basically, and you have to exfoliate that away. Once you do exfoliate that away, you'll see that new skin just looks so beautiful and smooth. It doesn't happen overnight, though. It takes a bit of time. Make sure that you're starting off slow. If you have never used retinol on your skin, then your skin is gonna have a big shock when all of a sudden your skin cells are turning over at a rapid pace. And so this is why I would always recommend to start at a very low percentage. Let your skin tolerate the ingredient, let your skin get used to it before upping the antics. So tip number two is to make sure that you're monitoring your skin. As you're starting off with this ingredient, it is going to be really important to make sure that you understand what your skin is doing. This means examining your skin. How is your skin faring? Is it getting red? Are you getting splotchy? Are you breaking out? Are you purging? What's going on? You really need to just look at your skin and listen to it. If you're using a retinol and it is too strong for you, your skin will tell you this. Yes, you will experience purging. Yes, you will experience discomfort. But if your skin is really stinging when you're using it, maybe it's time to dial back a little bit. My biggest tip for starting off with retinol is to, for the first week, use it once. Use it once at night. At the end of the week, examine your skin. How does it look? If your skin looks fine, if there's not any weird irritation on your skin, then for the next week, try using it twice a week. Depending on how strong the retinol is, in about 3 months, you should see some sort of difference on your skin. But if you don't, that is totally fine because it does take a couple of skin cell cycles to really see the benefits of retinol. The next tip has to do with the other ingredients that you're using alongside your retinol. As with most active ingredients, especially if you're trying a new one, you want to make sure that you're not using any other actives in that routine. So it's okay if you're using vitamin C, for example, in the morning, but just keep your evening routine simple. You want to use ingredients that incorporate hyaluronic acid, glycerin, any humectants in your routine, and anything with lipids or ceramides. These are going to really help to rebuild your skin barrier and ensure that whatever retinol you're using is not actually damaging the layers of your skin. Most people who watch my channel are acne-prone skin types who suffer from either cystic, hormonal acne, whatever the case may be on your skin. So you'll want to look for a retinol that comes in the form of a gel. Serums, gels, those would be the best for acne-prone skin. Cream forms of retinols are usually better suited for people with dry skin as well as mature skin. If you're combating aging specifically, you'll want to get a cream form, and then gel form, I would say generally, is for more acne-prone skin. So understanding what they're going to do for your skin is really important. But with that being said, depending on your skin type, for example, people with acne-prone skin that do have dry skin, it may be more beneficial for you to use a cream retinol. The next tip I have for you is going to be how to minimize irritation on your skin. My favorite way to do this is the sandwich method. Now this involves, of course, first cutting off all the active ingredients that you're using, because you only want to be using one at a time when you're getting yourself used to retinol. So you want us to start with a gentle, simple, basic evening routine. Your cleanser, maybe a toner, maybe another hydrator, and then your moisturizer. Once your moisturizer has soaked into your skin, apply a pea-sized amount of retinol. I mean like a pea, like the actual pea that you cook with. That's all that you need. You do not need a lot. A pea-sized amount, and then dab it all over your face. Rub it in. Rub it into the skin until it's dry, okay? Once it's dry on the skin, apply a second layer of moisturizer on top. This sandwich method is going to make sure that the product is not too strong on your skin. It's going to be providing what's called a buffer to ensure that there's something before the retinol touches your skin, an occlusive or emulsive layer like the moisturizer, and there's something on top to make sure that your skin is not drying out. This will really help to minimize irritation, minimize dryness on your skin, and just make your skin feel a lot more hydrated and supported. This method will definitely reduce the efficacy of your retinol, but it'll make it a lot more tolerated by your skin. And once your skin becomes even better tolerated by it, you can stop the buffering. You don't need to do it forever. Okay, the next tip is for anyone who has really dry or sensitive skin and you still want to get the benefits of using retinol. I would say to actually just put the retinol in your moisturizer, mix it together and use that on your skin. This is going to make sure that the retinol isn't too strong for your skin, and it's going to keep some of that moisturization and hydration in just one step rather than having to do the layering step if that's something that you don't have time for. So the next tip is for when your skin becomes a little bit more adjusted or better tolerated by retinol. You can actually just stop the sandwich method of the retinol and just use retinol at the end of your routine. So after you do your night routine and put on your moisturizer, let your skin sit for maybe an hour or so, 20 minutes to an hour, let it fully dry. And then apply your retinoid on top without applying another layer of buffer. If your skin is still getting a little bit dry, then you can still use the buffer, that's fine. But if you really wanna see faster results, you may want to just leave your retinol as the last step of your routine. That will make sure that you're not thinning out the product and it will give you better benefits on your skin. The next tip I have for you, I don't know what number I'm on, is to actually massage the retinol into your skin. The act of massaging your skin increases blood flow. It brings more blood to the surface and allows the ingredients to penetrate better into your skin. So if you're up for it and your skin is okay with it, try massaging the retinol into your skin, as it will actually increase its efficacy. This is one of the tips that I learned from an esthetician, and it really started to make a big difference in my acne-prone skin. Don't just apply it on your skin, actively work it into the skin. This goes for pretty much every active, vitamin C, retinols, niacinamide. If you actually massage it, it has a lot of great benefits. for greater penetration. You guys know that I'm not like the biggest fan of eye creams. I still use them now and then, but it's not something I'm gonna be like, oh my God, I need to spend money on that. There are eye creams that already have retinol in them. I know that the ENQUIRIES has a really great one for the under the eyes. That's one that you can look at, but you can actually just use your retinol with a little bit of moisturizer and use it under your eyes. There you go. You're preventing crow's feet and getting rid of your acne on your face at the same time with one product. The next tip has to do with purging. And this is something that a lot of people, myself included, were really afraid of when you're trying retinol for the first time. Everybody knows that purging can be really, really bad when you're using retinols. And for somebody who suffers from acne prone skin, it's something that you are trying to get away from. But the truth is, your skin will get worse before it gets better. That's how retinol works. The reason being is because on any given moment, if you have acne prone skin, there are acne lesions forming underneath the skin. Sometimes those lesions will come to the surface in, let's say, 2 weeks or 2 months. But what retinol is gonna do is quicken that time. So all the acne that is gonna come out in the next 2 months will come out in the next week. Which is scary, but it's a good thing because that means 2 months from now, there's nothing gonna be in your skin to come out. And that's why I have a love-hate relationship with purging. I think that a lot of people, when you start to see purging on your skin, you wanna stop what you're doing. With retinol, as long as your skin is not red or burning and whatever you're using on your skin is not causing more irritation and inflammation, it's definitely important to stick it out. Stick out the purging. Maybe reduce the amount of times that you're using retinol if you really can't stand it, but let the purging happen. It's supposed to happen. It means that everything in your skin is coming out, and that's a good thing. The next tip is regarding how long should you be using retinol for? So it's kind of up to you. When your skin problem, for example, acne, has sufficed and it's no longer reoccurring, and for a couple of months you don't really see anything there, you don't have to keep using, a really strong retinol on your skin. Retinol works by a compounding effect. So the more you use it, the better your effects will be because they will compound on each other. But where retinol is concerned, as well as a lot of other actives, they stay in your skin, sometimes for 2 to 3 months. So it's not necessary to keep using, let's say, adapalene after 9 months of using it and your acne is gone. You don't need to keep using it at that strong a percentage. It's not just about using retinol. There are other ingredients that your skin needs as well and that you can benefit from. So you don't need to be using such a strong form of retinol for forever. Once you've gotten your results that you're fine with, bring down the percentage. Maybe use an ester or even a plant alternative to just kind of upkeep the benefits that retinol provides. And then you can incorporate some of the other products into your routine. I mean, for example, when you're pregnant, you can't use retinol. So there are plant derivatives that you can use that don't actually have retinol in them to upkeep. The mentality that I would say to approach retinol is essentially work up your tolerance to be able to use something strong if you have a serious, you know, condition on your skin like acne. But once you're done with your acne, come back down. You don't need to be up there. Come back down and you can start using other things like BHAs in your skin, other things to just make sure that you're exfoliating the pores or whatever benefits that you need alongside your skin cells' turnover rate. So that's basically all I have for you guys today. I hope you enjoyed that video. Leave a comment down below with any questions that you have or any tips and tricks that you have if you've tried using retinol for your acne or otherwise. Remember to click over here to see some of my previous videos. And as always, stay gorgeous, stay fabulous, and I will see you, lovely ladies and gents, in the next video. Bye.